When the doors of the banks in Cyprus finally reopened, there was no panic. Instead, Cypriots lined up politely and waited their turn.
How's it going today?
As expected.
Patience and calm in a media circus, even though the crisis had forced banks to close for nearly 2 weeks.
The night before the banks reopened, the government imposed strict new rules to ensure that whatever money is left in the banks doesn't leave Cyprus. Depositors can only take out a maximum of 300 euros a day. Cashing of checks is basically prohibited. And you're only allowed to take about 1,000 euros, or the equivalent of $1,300 cash, off the island.
One of the Republic's biggest and oldest banks, Laiki, is effectively being closed for good, which is bad news for this retired philosophy professor.
I said I'm losing my money because I got all my money at Laiki Bank, and it will be closing now. And they said they will spread it into two, into a good bank and into a bad bank. So I'm losing my money.
Many business owners cannot afford to be philosophical.
How are you going to pay your employees?
This is a bigger problem now we will face. I say to them, you have two options. Even you stop
working.
Uh-huh. Or you continue with a half salary.
You're cutting salaries already.
Yeah, what I make if I don't have a job? They have family also. We have families. And all we are living together like a domino. If someone falls down, all will fall down.
Cyprus used to be a center for high-flying international finance. But this visiting European diplomat had little sympathy for Cypriot bankers or their foreign investors.
The days of Cyprus being a major international banking sector, they seem to be over.
That remains to be seen. I think the days of mismanagement of financial sector, I hope that that is distinctly over, not only here, but in other places as well.
With the help of a last-minute $13 billion bailout from Europe, Cyprus appears to have dodged total financial collapse. But once prosperous Cypriots know fully well, tough times are ahead for their small island. Ivan Watson, CNN, Nicosia.